Coronavirus Diaries. I'm a lesbian and I'm sleeping with my male roommate. My loneliness is killing me. I'm bi. Okay, let's go. Coronavirus Diaries. I'm a lesbian, but since the lockdown, I've been sleeping with my male roommate. And the subtitle reads, "The loneliness of isolation has meant identity is less important than intimacy." I will say that the original article read that way, but now they have since changed it and the title is a little bit better, but the subtitle is still shit. The new title reads, "Coronavirus Diaries, quarantine fling with my roommate has me questioning my sexuality." It's a little bit better. The subtitle is still shit. The loneliness of isolation has meant that identity is less important than intimacy. Girl, it's been a fucking month. And no, I'm not slut shaming. But seriously, I don't honestly know any lesbians that after a month of not getting laid would be like, you know what I really want? Some dick. I'm gonna read the article now. I'm just letting you know I might puke like halfway through it. As I ran my hand through my roommate's chest hair. Sorry. It hit me that I hadn't had sex with a man in 3 years. In my life, the chapter of heterosexual romance, I thought, was closed. But times are different now. Anything is possible in a pandemic. Anything is possible during a pandemic, really? I'm so sorry. It could be the end of time and I could be the most horny woman in the world. I still would not have sex with a man. I'd maybe let him eat me out, though. By the way, I started a new thread over on slug.com/Ariel. If you want, go and check it out. It is a brand new, super exclusive place for us to talk more in depth about the issues, the crazy issues that are going on in the community right now, in the lefty community, and I don't want you to get judged in the same way I do, so go over there. I think only like 50 people signed up last time I mentioned it, so if you do sign up, I'm probably more than likely going to comment on your posts, and we're gonna have a conversation, you know? The world was changing every hour, and for the worse. Once we kissed, I couldn't stop. I didn't feel the dread I felt once before with men. I didn't feel the pressure to feign pleasure. I wanted him, for real. What did the hookup mean about my identity? Was I bi now? I mean, yeah, it's actually like really quite that simple. Sexual orientation is a spectrum, right? Maybe instead of thinking that you were all the way over here, you're actually more like here, and that's okay. But girl, lesbian is such a more fixed sexual orientation. Stop co-opting the label if you don't fit it. And enough with the biphobia, it's okay to be bi. This is why I also hate the term identity now. People are now saying that they identify as a lesbian without romantically or sexually being attracted to women as a woman, that bi lesbians are valid. I do find it quite ironic though that progressives will scream cultural appropriation, but they are also appropriating the label lesbian, bisexual, and queer without being same-sex attracted. To me, if you enjoy having sex with men and women, or if you are romantically attracted to men and women, you are, in some sense of the word, bisexual, biromantic, you're bi. And yes, who you sleep with isn't always who you are attracted to, because if that was the case, then virgins would all be asexual. And if I had had sex with men in the past, I would automatically be bisexual. Like, no, I'm only attracted to women. I can argue even that the way you have sex with somebody doesn't define your sexual orientation. Because then would that mean a pillow princess because she doesn't want to give oral sex to her girlfriend? Does that mean she's less gay, in my opinion? No. Attractions, not actions. It's really sad now that we've come to a point in identity politics that my friend Mars said, we now live in a world that's too afraid to define what a man or a woman is, or a lesbian or a gay man is, but in a world where pedophiles are no longer afraid to promote pedophilia. Let that sink in. He is right though. So is this lesbian that is now attracted to a man bisexual? In my opinion, yes. Seriously though, one could argue why would somebody sleep with someone if they weren't attracted to them in the first place? But a few of you did bring up a really good point on Twitter. Mike Lee said, she's just prison straight. And somebody responded saying, that's what I was thinking. This is totally the opposite of gay for the stay. There are straight men who only engage in homosexual sex when in prison or in general when they're isolated. For some people, their sexual desires become powerful enough to overcome their sexual preference. That doesn't discredit their sexuality. And I kind of see where you guys are coming from, but I also think that this makes a lot of sense. Hannah said, identity is less important than intimacy, or put another way, your mistake was thinking that being a lesbian was about identity and not only wanting to have sex with women. I mean, call that bitch out, I guess. But I do think this is a really interesting conversation, but I wanted to see what my therapist friend had to say about this.
Within the grand spectrum of sexuality research, not many researchers or sex therapists like myself would be all that surprised by this. We would call this form of situational bisexuality. you know, for instance, situations in prison or the military, they really only have access to people of the same gender. It's a little more complicated than that, though, because we have to consider that there are other issues involved in sexuality. For instance, the level of a person's libido and sexual interest, their interest in sexual novelty, issues of intimacy, closeness. This, I think, is the really important thing that I find really interesting in this story, is that it helps us remember that sexuality is much more than just how we identify. Our sexuality being made up of roughly three components. Identity is one. Another is arousal in terms of who we physically respond to. And yet another is behavior.
Hi everyone, I'm Dr. Yoni Alkin. And Ariel, you were asking whether a lesbian having sex with a dude makes her not be a lesbian anymore? And I don't know how much I agree with that. Just like when you tell me that you're a lesbian, that's great. That gives me a lot of information about you, but it doesn't really tell me your whole story. But the real issue with what you're saying is that it kind of sounds to me the same guys being called gay for hugging someone for too long. It rings the same bell. It sounds similar, and that can be really toxic and dangerous. I understand the yearning for finding like a clear and defined word for us to communicate it, but it will never happen. We can't find one word that will define the whole human being.
Also, just because we're on the prison topic, I wanted to read this tweet from a woke dude bro, is, you know, what I've been calling them, that he sent to me about trans women sex offenders in women's prisons. This is what he said. Having male and female sex prisons isn't equality. High security prisons should be high security prisons, not male or female prisons. Toilets should be toilets, not disability toilets, not able-bodied toilets. We are human beings. Segregation is a discrimination. And I replied, segregation is discrimination if it's dehumanizing. None of those things mentioned are. Recognizing the difference between sexual orientations is not dehumanizing. Which brings me back to the fact that if you like having sex with men, you're not a lesbian. I'm so sorry. There's nothing wrong with saying that, though. It's crazy that I have to say this after 10 years of making lesbian content. I think I'm done for now. I think I've done enough ranting for the day. But let me know what you think. Does intimacy sometimes trump identity? For me, no. Honestly, I don't think I ever would. But that's just me. What do you guys think? Let me know in the comments. And if you are not subscribed, please subscribe. Because you know you're gonna continue to watch my videos where I drag the progressive left and call them out on their bullshit, so you might as well subscribe. And if you are not already, follow me on Instagram and Twitter, because I also post a lot of content on there. And I will see you guys back here in a few days with a brand new video. Until then, I love you. I love yourselves. Bye!